Everybody seems to be using AI for everyday tasks and processes. So it's a great time to learn more about AI models and how to build them and use them safely. Let's walk through the AI model lifecycle and focus on each stage from birth to retirement. First, let's make a plan. What do we want our model to do? Do we want our model to be conversational? What kinds of conversations will it have? Who will our users be? Let's say we want to design a model that will help users create delicious recipes from scratch. We don't want the model recommending glue instead of cheese. So we need to collect training data that's tailored for our use case and aligned with ethics and trustworthiness. Good AI starts with good data. Our model could be trained on conversational data, recipes from reputable sources, and solid cooking techniques. We want data that comes from diverse backgrounds and perspectives. And we should be able to trace every datum back to its source for reliability. Once we have what we need, let's cleanse the data by removing any PII, deduplicating, replacing missing values, and standardizing formats. Then, let's run bias checks. If the data is unbalanced, generating synthetic data to fill in the gaps is one way that we can create the balance we need. Now that we have our plan and training data, we're ready to develop the model. AI models can be developed with a variety of algorithms, methods, and architectures. For our conversational and instructional model, let's start with a transformer architecture. Transformer architectures are great at processing and generating text. Then, we can use a combination of small specialized models using a mixture of experts architecture to improve performance while decreasing computational and environmental costs. There are many other methods and considerations for building our model, but let's start with these to lay a strong foundation. Once we've built our model, it's going to need to be evaluated and validated. We'll need an AI governance review board in order to ensure that our model complies with regulations like the EU AI Act. We can check for accuracy, fairness, and bias by measuring performance across demographic groups and check for diversity in outputs. Let's brainstorm edge cases and test any possibility that we hadn't thought of before. If any disparities are found, we can adjust the algorithm or augment our data with synthetically generated data. Now our model has passed all the tests and it performs accurately and fairly. It's ready for deployment. Our deployment process should be repeatable, automated, and secure. First, let's choose our cloud platform. I'm partial to one of them. Next, we need to set up storage, compute, and networking. Then, we're ready to containerize and deploy. Once our model is deployed into production, ongoing monitoring, version control, and retraining will keep it healthy and trustworthy. Let's make sure our model continues to be fair and unbiased for routinely monitoring for drift. Drift is when a model stops performing the way that it once did. We also need to monitor performance metrics like throughput, latency, and error rates. We should plan for periodic retraining by setting up automated alerts and pipelines. And finally, we should plan for model retirement. Once our model isn't needed anymore, we can archive it to build from later. We've walked through the AI model lifecycle together, and we've talked about each of the stages. With thoughtful planning and development, we can build AI models that meet the needs of our users while preventing bias and drift and ensuring transparency and trust. What kind of model do you want to build? Let us know in the comments below.